Entrepreneur India is with the founder of the News Minute. It is a website, a startup based on South Indian content, and they spread out of Bangalore.
Yeah,
and they operate in five other states. So, Mr. Vellore, I want to ask you a couple of questions. Mm-hmm. A, the relevance of content. We are very, very structured and focused on South India. Mm-hmm. In the long run, how do you see this kind of model sustaining?
Okay.
And where do you see the revenue really coming from?
Okay. So, coming to the content part, okay, like I said earlier also, we realized that, you know, the news narrative of the South was being controlled by the desks which were based out of Delhi and Bombay. People who were based out of these desks, they were not able to understand the cultural sensitivities of the South.
Sure.
So there were a lot of content which was coming out which we felt was not being truthful to what was actually happening. There was a lot of content which was not actually being covered. So that's when we actually said, okay, fine, this is what we're going to do. So we went out there and said, see, you should also understand that how the southern content space works. There's a lot of content which happens in the vernacular space, doesn't get translated and comes around into the English space.
Okay.
So we felt that there were a lot of people who were from Karnataka, who were from Tamil Nadu, who understood what was going on, but they obviously could not consume the content because it was written in their vernacular languages. These people cannot read. So they have to go to a site and say, hey, where do I get this in English? That's exactly where the News Minute came in. From a sustainable model, like you said, yes, initially we had absolutely no ads, we had absolutely no revenue. Over the year, starting from last year, we've been able to focus on the business side of things. So we have obviously some kind of ads on the site, which is just to make sure that, you know, we can churn out some kind of revenue. But the bigger focus that we are doing right now is to work on sponsored content or native advertising. We have a content studio. It's called it's a branded content studio which works on content, specific content for brands. So we have an infinite scroll platform on our site. So we're able to write content and put it underneath every story that people are consuming on the News Minute. And that way we've been able to drive eyeballs for the brand itself.
So in your quest to actually generate revenue, do you feel that you'll be able to do justice to the objectivity that you had decided for News Minute in your initial years?
Yeah.
And how do you plan to really sustain that kind of model?
Okay. See, from the beginning itself, because if we were completely bootstrapped, we were a self-funded site, we decided that we're going to be as lean as possible. So today we function with a team of about 24 people. This is probably the leanest news house in the whole country. Okay, I think the closest competitors that we have from an independent media space, I think, have about 75 to 100 people. So we've been able to keep the costs down relatively, you know, low from that point of view.
Okay.
The other thing is, you know, we obviously cut a lot of costs in terms of the technical aspects, you know, in terms of the hosting facilities and all that stuff. So we've been able to function with a very minimal outflow of cash. We are right now not broken even or anything like that.
Yeah.
But we definitely believe that if we can continue with this kind of a lean model, we should be able to sustain ourselves at least in the near future. Obviously, funding plays a very big part in this. Okay, you cannot not take funding at this point in time. Because if you want to grow a media organization, it's not something that you can look at returns the next year or, you know, 2 years from now.
Yeah.
You want to build a brand. You want to build some kind of credibility before brands come to you and say that, hey, I want to advertise on your platform, which is what is happening right now. It didn't happen about 2 years back, but at least now brands are accepting the fact that, yes, sponsored content works, so I can, and I know that you guys are a brand, I know you guys are credible, so let me come out there and reach out to you guys.
And do you feel that the community that the News Minute has been able to build is going to be the driver for the News Minute to grow extensively in the next 5 years?
Yes. So obviously, you see, as of now itself, we have a lot of our readers who have written in to us and said that, you know, I know that you are publishing content in English. Why are you not moving into the other languages?
Right.
So one thing, obviously, it's there's a lot of cash involved. It's not like a Hindi, a terrain where you just convert your English content into one other language and then you go. We've got four different languages that we have to work on. So that itself, you know, takes a considerable amount of effort. It takes a considerable amount to build a complete team in that sense. But at least as of now, the community that we've been able to build, so right now, the credibility that we have, at least, when we go out and break a news, or if somebody else breaks a news, people write into us and say, hey, this is the news that I've heard, which is happening in Tamil Nadu or Telangana. If you guys verify it and you guys tell me it's true, then I'll believe it. So So that's the kind of, you know,
community
that we've been able to, you know, grow right
okay.
now. So,
mm-hmm. so being like a young entrepreneur, mm-hmm. media entrepreneur who's mm-hmm. looking to break even mm-hmm. the years to come, mm-hmm. your quick two tips or three tips for media entrepreneurs who are looking to get into the space, is that keep the cost low?
Yes, of course. Mm-hmm. So the two things that I always focus on, or I always tell people is, one thing is you have to stay lean. You know, we took a conscious effort not to go into the video space and start putting out videos because we knew that the production costs were very high. You had to have a big team in place. And right now, the model is such that you cannot monetize video, at least to sustain. So we said we'll stay away from videos. We only do videos because Facebook's algorithms are such that if you don't put videos, your content will not be discovered. That is one. Second thing is, the avenues of monetization. People think that, you know, you can create a website, put out content, I reach about 20, 30 million page views,
yes.
I have some 5 ads on my site, I will make money, I can sustain. No, that is not the case. It's not true. You have to start looking at other models of monetization. Today, like I said, we are trying to work on something called the branded newsroom. So we are trying to get brands to subscribe to our service, which says that you tie up with me for about 6 months or a year.
Okay.
And every month, based on some news cycle, we'll be able to put out branded content. That is another model. Events is a big space. I know a lot of smaller websites which have been able to break even or even become profitable
yeah.
because they've been getting into the event space.
Yeah.